Dear first year commerce students, my name is Munir Memon, and today's our discussion will be on accounting. This lecture is for especially those students who are related first year commerce or BBA. First of all, we define accounting. Simple definition of accounting is that accounting is the language of bookkeeping. Accounting is the language of bookkeeping. So, what is bookkeeping? Maintaining the books of accounts, maintaining the books of accounts is called bookkeeping, and we have two books of accounts in this time, which are journal and general ledger. These both are also the chapters of your book. After that, we have the standard definition. Which is accounting is an art of recording classifying and summarizing business or economic transactions in significant manners for the purpose of decision making. Main thing is that first of all we record this information in general journal, classify in ledger accounts, and summarize in trial balance. After that, we make income statement and balance sheet for the purpose of decision making. Okay, this is a standard definition. In our basic definition, we have discussed two things. Number one is bookkeeping, and number two is language. I have already told you some bit about bookkeeping, and now how accounting is a language. The qualities of language are any language has its terminology. English language has its terminology, Urdu language has its terminology, and other languages have their terminologies. So, if accounting is a language, then it means it must have its terminology, which is called terminology of accounting. And this terminology is divided naturally and basically on five parts, which are assets, liabilities, capital, income, expenses. These are five elements, five parts on which accounting terminology consists. Okay, so first of all, we are going to discuss assets. dictionary. The assets, definition of assets is anything which have cash value or cash or anything, cash or anything which have cash value is your asset. In business, resources, sources of business are assets. Assets are those which run the business, which run the business. Okay, and physically we have two types of assets tangible assets and intangible assets. Tangible assets means touchable. Intangible means not touchable. First of all, we have said that cash or anything which have cash value. It means cash is your asset which amount deposited into your bank, which is called bank, is your asset. Merchandise, inventory. Merchandise inventory, short form is M/R. Purchases for sale, जो चीज़ हम खरीदते हैं बेचने के लिए उसको कहते हैं merchandise inventory. If you have the business of rice, then rice is your merchandise inventory. If you have medical store, all the medicines are your merchandise inventory. And accounts receivable. Debtors, जिनकी तरफ आपका पैसा है, those are your accounts receivable. Furniture, equipment. Goodwill. These are all your assets. So you see that cash, bank, merchandise, inventory, account. furniture, equipment, building, and so on, all are touchable. So these are called tangible assets. And goodwill, reputation of the business. Achha naam, this is intangible. And intangible, you cannot touch any or person's reputation or any company's reputation, you cannot touch it. So it is called intangible asset. आप किसी भी कंपनी की रेपुटेशन को, किसी भी आदमी की रेपुटेशन को टच नहीं कर सकते हैं, इसीलिए उसको कहा जाता है इंटेंजिबल असेट्स. बाय द फंक्शंस वी हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ असेट्स. Number one, current assets. Number two, non-current assets. First of all, current assets. Current assets are those which are usable in current financial periods. Financial periods, we have two types of financial periods. Financial period may be 1 year, maybe for 6 months, for 3 months, for 1 month, for 1 week, for 1 day. जिस period का हम हिसाब किताब करके profit निकालते हैं, उसको कहा जाता है financial period. जो कि 1 साल का भी हो सकता है, 6 महीने का भी हो सकता है, 3 months का भी हो सकता है, 1 month का भी हो सकता है, 1 week का भी हो सकता है, 1 day का भी हो सकता है. आम ठेले वाले जो भी होते हैं वो एक दिन में रोजाना का रोजाना अपना हिसाब किताब करते हैं, उनका फाइनेंशियल पीरियड 1 day का होता है. लेकिन हमारे पास कॉमन जो फाइनेंशियल पीरियड होता है वो 1 year का होता है. और 1 year में हमारे पास दो किस्म के फाइनेंशियल पीरियड्स हैं. नंबर वन कैलेंडर ईयर, नंबर टू फिस्कल ईयर. कैलेंडर ईयर फ्रॉम 1 जनवरी टू 31 दिसंबर, फिस्कल ईयर 1 जुलाई टू 30th जून. इफ एनी एसेट विच इज फुली are partially usable is called current assets. Now we have current assets, cash, bank, merchandise inventory, all prepaid things, prepaid expenses, accounts receivable, office supplies, these are the examples of current assets. So number second is non-current assets. Furniture is not for only 1 year. It is for more than 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 5 years. Equipment machinery land building goodwill, these are all our non-current assets and these are also called fixed assets. Okay, after that we have liabilities. Now liabilities means payable, those amounts which are payable on business are our liabilities. Accounts payable, notes payable, bills payable, loan, bank loan are the examples of liabilities. After that, we have capital. Capital means investment by owner. It is also called proprietorship. Our owner's equity. After that, we have income. Revenues. There is some big difference this difference between income and revenues, which will I discuss later in our other lectures, but in this time, income, the other name of income is revenue. Means your जिसको हम उर्दू में कहते हैं आमदनी, ओके, इफ यू आर सेलिंग फिजिकल थिंग्स, इफ यू आर शॉपकीपर, यू आर सेलिंग physical things, medicines are physical things, other things, rice is physical thing, then your income will be sales. If you are a professional, then your income will be fees. Professional means teacher, doctor, engineer, lawyer, these are professionals and their income is called fees. If you are agent, then your income will be commission. If you are a broker, this is another name of agent, then your income is brokerage. After that, last element of your accounting terminology is expenses, expenditure, kharcha. Purchases, transporting expenses, rent expenses, salaries expenses, heat and light expenses, and other so many expenses come under the umbrella of expenses. Okay, our next lecture will be on accounting equation. Okay.